Well, hello, boys and girls. It's when I feel like a clock. I'm Pluralism. This is Saturday morning. I didn't have a chance to do a video last night, but I thought I'd do a quick one this morning on the games for today. I don't know if I'm going to get the first two games in, but we'll give it a shot. So yeah, I'm just going to get right at it because I don't really have all that much time this morning. But thanks for all the subscriptions and all of those sort of things. I'm at Pluralism. This is from B for B Pal Picks. I have a Patreon. You can go to the description, hit the link that I'll provide for you, and you can try it for free. Go to the $25 package and you can try it for free. So let's get to her, shall we? Real quick. I'm not going to go over the last night's games, although we hit really well. I'm just going to do it quickly like this. I got some letters and they said, well, you know, we don't need to know how you did yesterday because we can just go back to the videos that you did and you can make the video shorter if you just go straight to the pick. So let's try it, shall we? I haven't had all the time in the world to look over everything here. I'm going to be writing my analysis for Patreon after this video. Which will go deeper. That's why I highly recommend you go into it because it's an ongoing thing that when I'm watching, when I'm doing picks, it goes on through the day. First of all, goaltenders, of course, you know that. I also look at a whole bunch of statistics, everything, trends, and so on and so forth like that. And sometimes my picks change. But this is what my early morning stuff. So I've actually gone through quite a bit. And let's just go at it. Okay. First game of the day. Let me refresh this because we should have all of our odds now. First game of the day, we have the Rangers and New Jersey Devils. This is in a half an hour, so I don't know if I'm going to have this up by the time you guys need it. But I'll quickly say I'm going to take the Rangers here because Shesterkin is just rocking right now. I wouldn't doubt if he has three shutouts in a row against New Jersey. New Jersey's got a pop gun offense that doesn't, and the Rangers are just playing at a top level right now. Also, I'm going to go under 5.5. You're getting good juice on that, by the way. What was the money line on that? Yeah, the money line was 142. So we're going to go in reg. That should put you about 165. Total, and the total, I'm going to go under because I just don't think New Jersey is going to score enough on Shesterkin. I don't think the Rangers are going to blow out New Jersey on an afternoon game. So, afternoon games generally teams score less because they're out of rhythm. They're out of routine and it takes a while to get their legs moving. Hockey is a very routinary sport. The body reacts at different times, different ways. I know when I played, I hated afternoon games. It was hard to get the legs moving, especially in the first period. So maybe consider under 1.5 in the first period in this game. Same can be said for Washington, Philadelphia as well. I really like the under 6.5 here, and normally you wouldn't do that on a Washington Philadelphia game, as Philadelphia's defense is fairly poor, although they played very well defensively against Pittsburgh. Washington can score like crazy, and not only that, Philadelphia's got enough guns to score as well. But Samsonov will be in net for Washington. And Carter Hart, who had a good game last game, which is a sigh of relief for the Philadelphia Flyers fans and the organization, because they certainly need Carter Hart to turn out. It's like basically their whole organization is wrapped up in that happening. So I'm going with Washington here on the money line at 175, 172, I guess. I just think with Samsonov and net, and after losing to Buffalo, which was basically about a poor performance by Vanacek, that Washington is going to be pissed. It's going to put them back into Washington does that for every once in a while. They play down to their competition often, actually. Sometimes so much so that their competition takes advantage of that. In this case in particular, though, it was more to do with Vanacek really not having a good game. And I just, when they lose like that, they almost always come back gangbusters the next game. So, although Philadelphia played well against Pittsburgh, I can't right now trust that being a consistent, what's going to happen consistently. They haven't showed me over the year that, over this year that they were able to do that. And Washington has shown me over and over again that they have bounce back games, especially against bad losses like that. So I'm going to take Washington and I'm going to take the under 6.5. Pittsburgh versus Buffalo. This is actually a tough game to cap. It's possible, very possible. Pittsburgh did not look really their best against Philadelphia. As far as standings are concerned, Pittsburgh's kind of comfortable right now. And it's getting late in the season, and there's so a lot of times there's dips where you kind of go, okay, this will be an easy game. It's just a mindset. Now, the thing is, with Pittsburgh, generally, they don't have too many games where they play down to their competition. They generally play to crush the competition. Crosby kind of think instills that in the whole organization. With Tokarski in net, I mean, for Buffalo, and what'll likely be Jarry. This is also an afternoon game, but it's a later afternoon game. Those other games were morning games, by the way. At six. I think I'm gonna go under six, and I'm gonna go Pittsburgh. But honestly, I'm afraid to go money. I'm afraid to go in reg against Buffalo right now. Their energy, they're really confident coming off a win against Washington. They will be really confident, but I'm going to. There's just no. It doesn't make sense to go money line on this. So I'm going to go in reg. And that'll pay about 160, but I'm not going to put a lot on this game. Ottawa versus Montreal. Montreal kind of redeemed themselves with their win against Calgary, the last game. I think it'll still be Allen. I don't think Price is going to be back yet, so I'm going to go Montreal. Again. You can get 150. I would go money line, seriously. Montreal's not giving me a whole lot of confidence right now. I wouldn't even surprise if Ottawa took this. But with Murray in net, and that's likely the case, but let's go check that out. I don't even have to read this. Oh, look at this. I did not know this. Alex Lyon is going to be in for Philadelphia. Yeah, Capitals all day. All day. Alex Lyon is very average goaltender in the NHL. They still haven't said who's going to be in net for the Sabres. And they're on the front part of a back-to-back. So, let's look at our weekly here. And see what their second part of the back-to-back is. Oh, it's Pittsburgh again. So, I mean, they could. I don't know who their fourth string goaltender is. We'll see. Either way, I still take Pittsburgh in that game. What was I looking? Oh, Montreal. Montreal's playing Ottawa tomorrow, so they're probably going to play their better goaltender here. So that'll be no, that's Ottawa. What's going on here? What is it? There, they're playing Ottawa, and they're on a back-to-back. You know what? I'm gonna take Ottawa. I'm gonna take Ottawa here. I didn't. Ottawa at least puck line. At least take the spread. 174, yeah. Take Ottawa puck line. Montreal be on a back to back against Calgary last night, and Ottawa is, I mean, Ottawa is a hard-working team. I would not want to play against them if I'm on a back-to-back. St. Louis, Arizona. I got to go with St. Louis. I think this is a really important game, and I'm sure Arizona is going to be coming out full bore. But Binnington has been playing very good as of late, and I think the play more than anything here, though, is under 5.5. Ranta will be in net against Binnington. It's a tight game. This is going to be a very important game. I'm slightly going to go to St. Louis on the money line, but it's not my best. I don't think it's the best play. I think Arizona could very well win this game, I think. I think the best play is the under 5.5 for that game. Nashville, Carolina. I'm sticking with Carolina all day. Nashville's been very injured. Their goaltending is good, but I believe this should be Mrazek. No, it's Nedeljkovic. Oh, yeah, for sure. He's by far the better goaltender right now. So, yeah, we'll take Carolina, ML, and under. For sure, under on that. That's got to be 5.5. Yeah, under 5.5. Tampa Bay, Florida. An over-under of 6. Under. Vasilevsky should be in net. Oh, Bobrovsky. I'm going to take Tampa Bay because I just don't trust Bobrovsky. Although, Tampa Bay was totally outplayed by Florida last game. They burnt me several times this year, so I'm only money lining that. But I don't trust Bobrovsky. I still don't. So I'm going to say probably under 6 still. It's a rivalry type game, and it also has playoff ramifications for Florida. I think it'll be really tight. So under 6. Detroit versus Chicago. I'm going to keep on going to Detroit against Chicago. I just think they line up really well against them. And Chicago's injured with DeHaan and Boqvist on their defense, which was fairly thin all year. They've been getting by with a very young club, and they have a lot of players that are going to be wearing down right now that aren't used to what the NHL is as far as the grind of the NHL. It's hard, especially when you're a young player that your body hasn't fully developed yet physically. Very difficult. So, Edmonton versus Winnipeg. I'm going Winnipeg, especially with Ekman Larson out. Is this a 6.5? That's a 6. That's probably the total right there. If you could bet the total, that would probably be it. But I'm going to say under 6. With Nugent Hopkins out, Hullabuck in net. I think Winnipeg will win fairly convincingly. I'd even almost go in reg there. I seriously don't trust Edmonton without Nugent Hopkins in net. And McDavid Draisaitl is wonderful, but their whole team in general is nowhere near as strong as Winnipeg's. Winnipeg's depth will ruin a lot of teams, and Edmonton, especially a team like Edmonton. I don't think they line up well at all. Columbus versus Dallas. I'm sticking with Dallas here. I'm going to go. I made a mistake. I think I went over last time. If it's going to be Corpusalo in net, which I bet we don't have. Oh, yeah. Bernier is going to be in net, too. So, yeah, absolutely. Under 5.5. For the Red Wings game with Bernier and net and Detroit winning. It's going to be Ottinger. Ottinger's fantastic. He's really good. And it says Merzlikins now. If it's Merzlikins, I'll go under. If it's Corpusalo, I'll go over. Corpusalo is just not good, man. It's not good. It's Minnesota, San Jose. Minnesota all day. San Jose gave their best effort. I think this is a back-to-back too, right? Ooh, let me check that. That's very important. Calgary Kakinen versus possibly Coronar. Okay, yes, over 5.5, which we kind of got screwed on yesterday because it was 3-2. But this will not be. This will not be under. I'm pretty sure if Coronar is going to be in net, he wasn't even good in the AHL. Wild are just crazy. I don't like going over on back to backs, but with that kind of goaltending, I'm going to say over 5.5 and Wild in regulation. Well, that's my full 42, boys and girls. That's all I have to give. I'm going to go take off real quick and get this out. Hopefully you can get the early games and everything. Have a great day. Lots of love to you. Oh, yeah. Don't forget to subscribe so I can send you my NHL Pearls of Wisdom necklace. How Pearl popped right to your door and signed by me. In fact, I'll even get it signed by all the Steel Flyers crew, which is www.steelflyersnet.com, the Steel Flyers Network. All the fine people there. Steel, Peyton on the Radio, the Prize, Peyton on the Radio, Off the Wall Hockey, John the Goat, and the Professor on Sports Fanatic News. Unbelievable. Go check them out. They're fine. They're great. Have a great day, everybody. Lots of love to you. Okay, bye.